The research that we do, ultimately, the guiding principle is to kind of impact human health. Once we can understand what's going on, we can begin to understand maybe other ways to help individuals that have been impacted early on. We're able to build things by collecting and having support from the College of Science, Engineering, and Technology, the Undergraduate Research Center, the College of Graduate Studies, as well as research and sponsored programs. The Sharlin Lab is a basic kind of research lab where we involve undergraduate and graduate students. Interacting and mentoring students in the research setting is one of my favorite things. A lot of times they kind of teach you how to be the mentor. I want the experience to kind of give them two things. I want them to develop technical skills, and I want them to understand research process and how that works. But I also want them to develop analytical skills. I want them to learn how to interpret data, also interact and present their data, and feel comfortable to talk about what they're doing.
Working with Dr. Sharlin has increased my confidence a lot. He'll work with you instead of against you, and that's been super important for me as I learn some of the harder techniques and get going on my own project. My aunt actually has a thyroid disease, so it's been really cool to be able to work hands-on with thyroid hormone and some of the developmental effects in an effort to hopefully prevent them in the future. It's been super rewarding to just be a part of the lab.
It really has broadened my experience, even just being a junior, and it allows me to have a creative space. It's more of an independent work and being given that trust to continue his research and our own research. It has allowed me to prepare for the future and be independent.
The lab has students in all of these places. We have graduate and undergraduate students that are working in industry, graduate and undergraduate students that have gone on to PhD programs, to dental school, to PA programs. So by having graduate students also work with undergrads, it just allows us to have a larger and more cohesive team.
He really comes with us and teaches us how to do everything that we need to know. And then he lets us get more independent as time goes on. And I think that's been really helpful for me.
I think it's been a really good experience so far. I think all that we've been learning has really added to what we've learned, not only in our undergrad, but also what we're still learning now. We're actually able to apply those lecture textbook concepts to real world, like hands-on experience through doing this research in the lab.
A lot of the techniques we use in the lab are very process driven. So you have this first step and then you move on to the next step. And you know, depending on Talia's project is very kind of animal tissue based, you know, and each one of those is a new technique that you're learning and building on. Whereas Kendra's project is very molecular, working with things in a test tube you can't see, and also very kind of step-by-step process driven. And so it's nice because there's a linear kind of growth to it, and you build a toolbox of techniques as you kind of work through your projects. My goal is to help them reach their goals. If they want to go and get a job, I want to give them the skill sets so they can get that job. They want to go into a PhD program, I want to make sure that they're going to be a solid applicant for that program.
Overall, I think we both hope that everything goes well and that we're able to contribute something to the science community.
Students' work is always exciting and, you know, often surprising in that we sometimes see things we just don't expect. And so those experiences are just building these kind of professional skills that when they need to go off to a job and maybe write a report, they have some experience doing it in the real world. Research is part of the education process.
Welcome to the Sharlin.